Good morning, good morning. My name is Jeffrey.
My name is Lana.
On behalf of Father Healy, the Faith Formation team, and all the First Communion students, a warm word of welcome is extended to all present. Everyone joining us through live stream, and especially to those who may be visiting or among us for the first time. Thank you for celebrating our first Holy Communion with us. Please participate in the Mass using the programs provided.
Immediately following Mass, we ask that students and families proceed out the main door. Our photographer Judy Warren will take individual photos of each child to later be put into our traditional group photo. Pictures and videos will be available on our parish website. Please now join us in this celebration of the Mass. Please stand.
Our opening hymn is number 768, Gather Your People.
Here today on what is a very happy occasion, but also a very seriously holy one, when these young people have now reached that point of spiritual maturity that they are prepared now to receive that special food that is meant to sustain us not only through this life, but for the life to come. So in that spirit today, let us begin our prayer in thanksgiving. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. In order to prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries, let us first call to mind our sins. You raise us to new life, Lord, have mercy. You forgive us our sins, Christ, have mercy. You feed us with your body and blood, Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace on earth, peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you.
Let us pray. O God, may your people exult forever in renewed youthfulness of spirit, so that rejoicing now in the restored glory of our adoption, we may look forward in confident hope and to the rejoicing of the day of our resurrection. We pray this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Let us be seated now as we listen attentively to the Word of God, and Olivia DePina will proclaim for us our first reading.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. The highest priest said to the apostles, "We told you plainly not to teach in the name of Jesus, but look what you have done. You've been teaching all over Jerusalem, and you are trying to blame us for his death." Peter and the apostles replied, "We don't obey people, we obey God. You killed Jesus by nailing him to a cross, but the God our ancestors worship, raised him to life, and made him our leader and savior. Then God gave him a place at his right side so that the people of Israel would turn back to him and be forgiven. We are here to tell you about all this, and so is the Holy Spirit, who is God's gift to everyone who obeys God. They had the apostles beaten with a whip and warned them to not to speak in the name of Jesus. Then they let them go. The apostles left their council and were happy because God had considered them worthy to suffer for the sake of Jesus. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from Revelations. I, John, looked and heard the voices of many angels who surrounded the throne, and the living creatures and the elders. They were countless in number, and they cried out in a loud voice, "Worthy is the Lamb that was slain to receive power and riches, wisdom and strength, honor and glory and blessing." Then I heard every creature in heaven and on earth and under the earth and in the sea, everything in the universe, cry out to the one who sits on the throne And to the Lamb be blessing and honor, glory and might forever and ever. The four living creatures answered, Amen. And the elders fell down and worshipped. Thank the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
We invite you to please stand.
With you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. When the disciples got out of the boat, they saw some bread and a charcoal fire with fish on it. Jesus told them, "Bring some of the fish you just caught." Simon Peter got back into the boat and dragged the net to shore. In it were 153 large fish, but still the net did not rip. Jesus said, "Come and eat." But none of the disciples dared ask who he was. They knew he was the Lord. Jesus took the bread in his hands and gave some of it to his disciples. He did the same with the fish. This was the third time that Jesus appeared to his disciples after he was raised from death. The Gospel of the Lord. If God isn't as merciful as we hope he is, then when we have to meet him face to face, he's going to ask us to sing a hymn by heart, all verses, and he's going to ask us to recite a psalm. Now, most of us will probably try the 23rd, the one we know the best, huh? The Lord is my shepherd. We have 150 beautiful psalms that come to us from 3,000 years ago. And the church has always made them, as the Jewish people before us, our communal prayers. One I'm thinking of today is Psalm 139. I will praise you, Lord, because I am awesomely and wonderfully made. Huh? The psalmist wrote that 3,000 years ago. Huh? Let's think about that. I mean, he's saying something that we know even better than him is true, because we have things like microscopes and x-rays and CAT scans, and so we really know a lot better than him how we were made, huh? But how are we made? What's the basic building block of every single one of us? A cell, huh? Yeah. Do you know how many cells each of us have? How about 30 to 40 billion, each and every one of us? Think of how many cells are in this room right now, huh? It's a small material thing, but when you think about that, that number is astronomical. But a cell is so important. Every cell has its own little engines and that keep it alive, that keep it breathing, keep it doing its job.
Its job is to do what the system it belongs to is supposed to do, keeping us thinking or seeing, talking, hearing, walking, learning, all those wonderful things that we can do. We are awesomely and wonderfully made. There's no question of that. But we have to ask, can a cell exist on its own? No. A cell needs to belong to the body because it's the body that feeds the cell, huh? By the blood circulating and bringing oxygen and nutrients to the cells, huh? I hope all of you will always take a very keen interest in science, especially biology, because you know what? We learn a lot about God from biology, and we learn how incredible is the one who created us, huh? With such systems and such ability. You know, our brains are smarter than any computer, believe it or not, huh? And work faster and better. So always appreciate that and give thanks to God because you are wonderfully and awesomely made. But when we think about it, if we take one of our cells out of our body, what's going to happen? It's going to wither up and die, huh? Or if we cut off the circulation to some part of our body, what's going to happen? That part is going to wither and die. And that's a good analogy to the body of Christ. Every one of us is, in a sense, a cell in the body of Christ since the day of our baptism, when we were invited by Jesus to be part of his mystical body, huh? But like the cells of our body, we also need to be nourished, or we will wither up and die. And that nourishment is going to be given to you for the first time today. Because I said at the beginning, you've now come to a certain stage where, like in life, you started out with baby food, huh? Now you're mature, and you can take the food the adults take, but in the spiritual sense too, and that food is the Eucharist. We see in this gospel today that when Jesus meets his disciples again after his resurrection, this time he's on the Sea of Galilee, he's on the shore, they're fishing in the water. When he invites them in, what's the first thing he wants to do? He wants to feed them, huh? And nourish them. And that's what he wants to do for you too, because he knows out of love that you need the nourishment that he himself has to give you. So the lesson today is, remember who we are, not only as biological beings, but as spiritual ones too. Since our baptism, cells in the body of Christ. We can't live apart from that body. We need the nourishment that Jesus gives us through that body. And where do we find it? Here, in Jesus' own body and blood, from this day forward until the day we meet him face to face. So get ready to sing the song and recite the psalm.
We stand now and profess the faith we accepted on the day of our baptism. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. And we invite the Chevrier family to come forward now as they lead us in our prayers of petition. As the people of the baptized, we do as Jesus has asked us to do, offering prayers not only for our needs, but for the church and for the world in which we live. And let us respond to the prayers. Lord, hear our prayer.
For Pope Francis, successor of St. Peter, and all clergy called to serve the church, may they feed the Lord's flock and follow wherever Christ leads. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the nations of the world and their leaders, may they submit to the glory of the Holy Spirit, who calls all people to live together in peace. Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who earn their living from the sea, especially those here on Cape Cod, may they be kept safe and may their catch be bountiful. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For vocations to ordained ministry in the church, may those who are invited by the Lord to feed his flock respond readily and generously. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those whose lives are in turmoil because of wildfires, destructive storms, and other natural disasters, that they may be given what they need to rebuild their homes and their lives, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the people of Ukraine, as they continue to fight to maintain their independence, that they may be strengthened by many prayers and sustained by much practical assistance in these difficult days, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those in our parish celebrating the sacraments of initiation during this Easter season, especially the young people receiving Holy Communion for the first time, may they always hunger for and the weakly receive the bread of eternal life. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are enduring afflictions of the body, mind, or spirit, that the good news of Christ's resurrection will help them to persevere in faith and hope in the midst of their sufferings, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who glorify the name of God in life, may all of the faithfully departed share in Christ's raised glory. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the people of the parish, whom we may remember in our prayers in a special way at this Mass, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those opposed intentions, which you now mention in silence, we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer.
Gracious God, open our eyes to recognize your risen Son as he continues to reveal himself to his disciples and the world through the worship, witness, and good works of your church. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Let us be seated now as we prepare the altar to celebrate this special Eucharist.
Our hymn for the preparation of the gifts is number 417, Two Were Bound for Emmaus.
Stand and together pray that my sacrifice and yours will be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. Receive, O Lord, we pray, the offerings of your exultant church, and as you have given us cause for such great gladness, grant also that the gifts we bring may bear fruit in perpetual happiness. We pray this through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time, above all, to laud you yet more gloriously when Christ, our Passover, has been sacrificed. By the oblation of his body, he brought the sacrifices of old to fulfillment in the reality of the cross. And by commending himself to you for our salvation, he revealed himself to be the priest, the altar, and the lamb of sacrifice. Therefore, filled with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Eucharistic prayer. You are indeed holy, Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by that same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. As we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis our Pope and Edgar our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Stand up.
And as baptized members of the one family of faith, the body of Christ, let us use the words Jesus has given us to pray and ask our Heavenly Father to give us our daily bread. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who on the day of your glorious resurrection appeared before your disciples, saying, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us turn and offer to one another a sign of Christ's peace.
Have mercy on us, have mercy on us.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Jeffrey Hammonds. Lana Beloyne. Olivia DePina. Owen Chevrier. Brianne Chevrier. Everett Cochran. Maggie Bedito. Carter Morris. Colin McDonald. Crosby Davies. Emmy Riker. Jacek Katowski. Mateo Martin. Matthew Hagen. Wesley Spinner. Aiden Brennan. William Jansen.
And all who drink shall live. Lord of all, give us light, deliver us from evil. Make us one, be our shield, make still the winds that blow. Cradle us with
let us stand to pray. O Lord, look with kindness upon your people, and grant, we pray, that those you are pleased to renew by eternal mysteries may attain in their flesh the incorruptible glory of the resurrection. We pray this through Christ our Lord. Before we go, we say a sincere word of thanks to Kathy Laird and all the catechists and assistants who helped her bring these young people to this day through their catechesis here in the parish. They work very hard, and certainly in these different times under strained circumstances, but I think with great dedication they've done a great job, so we thank them very, very much. We thank all who assisted in this liturgy today by reading, or Donnie and Anthony providing us the music, and our dedicated servers who are with us as well, so thank all of them. But in a very special way, we thank you, the families of these young people, and in a particular way, the grandparents, because we know how much parents have on their plate, and oftentimes it is the grandparents who, in a very particular way, are the ones who, by their prayers, their faith, their example, are the ones who spur the growth of faith in young people. I can think of my own grandmother, my father's mother, and my mother's father. By their example, how much they taught me. And I remember the great honor, and I never forget, that I received my first communion on my grandfather's birthday. And it was very, very special. I still have that picture on my bureau to this very day. And let me tell you, that was a long time ago. Anyway, so grandparents and parents, families, thank you for all you do. But continue. We must always bring young people to be nourished by Jesus as he wants to feed them in his word and in the sacrament, so that they may grow in faith, a faith that's desperately needed in these times in which we live, in order to live by gospel values, swimming against oftentimes the culture in which we live. So please, bring your young people regularly to the Eucharist, so that they can be strengthened as Jesus wishes to strengthen them. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. The Mass is ended. We go in peace to love and to serve the Lord.
Our recessional hymn is number 415, Alleluia, Alleluia.